Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be doing my July wrap up. I was able to read 6 books this month, which was actually really, really good for me. I think that's the most books I've read in a month this entire year, so I'm pretty proud of that. That is mostly due to the fact that I took part in the Booktubeathon. I did a TBR and a wrap up for that. I will leave the links below to those videos. But yeah, without further ado, I'm just going to jump in to these 6 books that I read this month. So the first 2 books I was able to finish this month were Spirit Bound and Last Sacrifice. These are the last 2 books in the Vampire Academy series by Richelle Mead. Basically, I decided back in May to reread this series, and it took me so long to get through it, mostly because I was working and I just really wasn't in the mood to read. But I was able to finish this series off finally, and I really, really enjoyed it. I don't know why it took me so long to finish, because I really did just fly through these, and I'm just really happy that I reread them because I did like them just as much as I did when I first read them in 8th grade. Basically, Vampire Academy takes place in a world where there are vampires, obviously, but there are different kinds of vampires. There are the Morari. I cannot pronounce it for the life of me, so like, this is just how I pronounce them. I'm sorry if I'm wrong. The Morari, who are like full-blood vampires, but they're the good ones and they only feed in small increments. The Damphers? I don't really know. Who are half Morari, half human, and they are like the guardians of the Morari. And then the Strigoi, which are the evil ones, the ones who kill and basically are immortal and stuff like that. And it's the story of Rose and Lyssa, and they are spirit bound, which you learn more about throughout the series, and you learn more about the magic elements in the series, and there's a lot to this. I totally forgot how much there was. I thought I remembered like everything that happened, but I definitely didn't. I was still totally taken by surprise, and I am so, so happy that I reread these books. Next up, I read The Unexpected Everything by Morgan Matson. This was the first book I was able to finish as a part of the Booktubeathon. This is the story of Andy. She's a congressman's daughter, and basically she has her whole life planned out, and she's got her whole summer planned out as well, which like coincides with her life plan, and she's got everything figured out, and then something totally throws a wrench in those plans, and she has to rethink everything and replan her summer. And basically, as the cover would imply, she gets a job as a dog walker, and that pretty much sets her entire summer into motion. And it is such a cute, fun read. It didn't get like too deep or too dark, which was nice. I read some other books this month that seemed really light and fun and then turned really dark, but this pretty much kept it light, kept it summery, kept it fun, and I was so happy I read this because this is the perfect summery young adult contemporary read. I gave this 4 out of 5 stars on Goodreads. I didn't say this before, but I gave Spirit Bound 4 stars on Goodreads and Last Sacrifice 5 stars on Goodreads. Next up, we have We Were Liars by E. Lockhart. This is the favorite book that I read all month. I didn't think I was gonna like it because I heard some very mixed reviews on it, but this is so up my alley. It was a lot darker than anything else I read this month. It was very mysterious, very ominous. It is about a girl. Well, actually, no, I'm not gonna tell you about it because I think it's way better to go in blind and not really know much. I'll read you the back. This is a super like hyped up book, so you've probably already heard about it, but I will read you the back just to increase the mystery. And it says, "We are Sinclairs. No one is needy. No one is wrong. We live, at least in the summertime, on a private island off the coast of Massachusetts. Perhaps that is all you need to know, except that some of us are liars." This drew me in and did not let go of me until it was 4 a.m. And this was such a good book. I really enjoy it. Do not believe those weird reviews that say you're not going to like it. If you like darker stuff, if you like kind of Gillian Flynn, this is definitely lighter than that, but still kind of ominous and creepy, and I just love it so, so much, and I'm so happy I read this, and I gave this 5 out of 5 stars on Goodreads. And the last 3 books I read were the Summer I Turned Pretty novels by Jenny Han. I read these back in middle school yet again. These were rereads, but I wanted something summery for the readathon, and then I ended up just finishing off the series, and I am so glad that I did because I don't remember this being as deep and meaningful as they were. There were a lot of immature moments, which makes sense. These are like middle school grade books, and like you're not gonna get like adult romances and stuff from it. The Summer I Turned Pretty is about a girl named Belly and her summers at the summer house in Cousins Beach, and basically her friends there, the boys there, and kind of just how she grows up that summer. And yeah, it was kind of the most immature book of this series, and I think I gave it 3 out of 5 stars just because Belly is super annoying in this book, and I just didn't really appreciate her character all that much, to be honest. The last two books I gave 4 out of 5 stars each, just because they definitely got to be deeper and more in-depth and more meaningful stories. They weren't really about this 15-year-old girl who, like, whines a lot. It was more about, like, real-life stuff, and it was pretty heavy. Like, they really had some deep moments, especially in It's Not Summer Without You. There was a lot of meaning and depth to it, which I really appreciated. This one went kind back to immature and a little bit annoying, but not nearly as bad as the first book. I finished this, I think I finished all three of them in one sitting, which was cool, but yeah, I think my favorite was probably this one, just because this one has a very interesting storyline that I kind of just got really fed up with after a while, but like I did end up enjoying, I appreciated the ending and stuff like that, so I did give it 4 out of 5 stars, but I might repeal it back to 3 just because the more I think about it, the less I liked the story. So yeah, those are the 6 books that I read in the month of July. I really hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for watching. Comment, like, subscribe, all the normal stuff, and I'll see you guys again next time. Bye!